My father, Oliver Heywood, was a landscape painter. This is one of his last paintings, painted in 1992, just before he died. It is unsigned. He never found the time. The previous summer, he and Denise, my mum, had been to North Uist in the Outer Hebrides, walking, looking, Dad sketching and mum taking photographs. Then they came home and Dad started to paint, using his sketchbook, mum's photographs, and whatever else he might have gathered. This is one of the pictures that emerged from that trip. It's been hanging now above our family fireplace for a long time. But it's much more than a view of a beach. Here's Dad giving a talk.
Now I want to try a little experiment on you. You'll see a simple design, and immediately your mind starts trying to make it into a description of something, probably. So I'm going to help you by giving it a title. I'll call it Three Stones on a Beach. Now I'm going to switch the title. I'm going to call it Three Holes in a Screen. And quite quickly, I think you'll find you can come to terms with that different interpretation. But after a while, you can accept it both at the same time as part of a whole statement, a single image.
Yes, the rocks are there, strewn along the shoreline, but there's more to it than that. It's as though they are suspended. They have a lightness, as though you could look through them. The place and beyond the place, to observe and record what he saw with his eyes, and yet at the same time to look further, to see rocks, yet know them as sea-worn, time-worn, before their molten state, before. I have the sketchbook from North Uist, and I was amazed when I first found the sketch for our painting. As always, there are notes about colours and textures. I love looking at his sketches because they shed light on the process. They are beautiful, yet for him they are a means to an end, working towards the making of a painting. And here in the corner, on Oronsay Isle, I found it on the map, Oronsay or Oronsay Isle on North Uist. It was a long way from his home near Stroud. Dad started painting full-time in 1948. He began as a watercolourist with closely observed details of birds and landscapes. And then around 1960, he was caught by the mood of the times and his paintings changed completely, large abstracts in oil. He was throwing off convention and finding a new freedom. And then as time went on, he gradually developed his lasting, distinctive style. A dialogue between the representational and the abstract, an eye for the here and now, but with ways through, beyond the definable.
Thank you.
Northwest, early September. The light and the weather constantly changing. Dad, you sat here in the wind, trying to select and record what you saw, to draw a landscape, to distill it later into a painting that is, although still, a way through to change, to motion. On our first evening, I went off to look for Loch Nan Giran. Where I struck off from the road was an abandoned croft. I took a photo, peered into the empty rooms and thought no more about it. Weeks later, I woke in the night, wondering if it was where Mum and Dad had stayed 29 years before. And then a friend who had been there with them wrote, "Yes, that's the place." It was very basic. Up behind was a loch, the only place to wash. I headed off and found the loch. It felt like I was quite close, with rocks emerging from the water, similar hills in the background. But no, it was never quite right. And yet I found a richness there and delighted in the detail of your work.
29. Pale, milky green, straggly star. Twenty-six. Deep, rich, burnt sienna orange moss heads against rich gold green.
'He made so many sketches, the hand and the eye, the constant dialogue. He and Mum would be up and out by 6 in the morning along the cliffs and estuaries. Grimanish Point. I'll walk out there. I'm high up, with the sea pounding into the bay below, but still not quite the right place. Midsummer day, very cold and windy. He died at midsummer, a year later, within a day. Fulmers flying V close. Look at the marum grass. Look, here's the beginnings of the same kind of rocks. These rounded rocks. That's interesting. Look at this. Look at this. Come on, Dad, show me. Thank you. So this, as far as I can make out, is where you sat to sketch. The rocks have gone, covered in sand, presumably, after nearly 30 years. And you've condensed this view into your frame. It's interesting that you walked so far out across this tidal estuary and chose this quite uneventful place. Perhaps it was the simplicity you liked, the clarity, the place, and beyond the place, both at the same time. For you, journeying here was important. I think you were drawn to the simplicity of the edge, to a place where light and space, land and sea coexist elementally. And we've come now to the edge. And you are still so present in this place, bearing witness to the power and wonder of nature. Thank you.